Let's see how to install Ubuntu using the manual option. I'll start by choosing Install Ubuntu. And here we can choose our keyboard layout. I'll go with English US. And personally, I don't really use many of the applications that come with a normal installation, so I'll go with a minimal installation. But you can, of course, go with a normal installation. And since we want to use the manual installation, I choose something else. Here you can see the disk that I have in my computer. In my case, both of these disks are new and empty, but if they had any partitions of them, we would see these partitions here. Anyway, we can click here, and we can see that SDA has about 80 gigabytes, whereas SDB has about 60 gigabytes. So I want my Ubuntu installation on SDA. So I make sure that I choose SDA from here, from this list, and then we create a new partition table for SDA. And we get a warning that says that if we create a new partition table, all of the partitions that currently exist will be deleted. I currently don't have any partitions on this disk, so I have nothing to lose. But you should notice that if you create a new partition table, the partitions you currently have on this disk will be deleted. So a new partition table was created, and currently it only has free space, and all of the disk space is currently this free space. So let's create our first partition on this free space. So let's click on the plus icon. And the first one is going to be the EFI system partition. 500 megabytes should be more than enough for this partition, so that's what I'll go with. And for use as, I'm going to choose, of course, EFI system partition. And OK. So it leaves 1 megabyte of free space empty. This 1 megabyte won't be used. And then we have our EFI system partition. And as you can see, its size is about 499 megabytes. Next up is going to be the swap partition. So I choose the free space again and create a new partition. Now, generally speaking, the disk space for swap should be based on the amount of RAM you have on your computer. In old machines, it was recommended to have more swap than your physical RAM memory. But in modern systems, it's usually not really necessary. In this computer, I have 6 gigabytes of RAM, so that's what I'll allocate for swap. So 6 gigabytes is about 6,000 megabytes. Now, some people would say that even this is too much, but I can afford the disk space, so why not? As for the use as, I'm going to choose swap area. And OK. And here we can see our swap partition right after the EFI system partition. Let's choose free space again and create our next partition. Now, here comes the big question, to split or not to split. So generally, there are two attitudes or two ways to go about it. The first one says that you should split. In other words, that you should have one partition for your root and then another partition for your user files. The main advantage with this approach, the separation approach, is that your files, such as documents or music files or video files, have their own partition. So if you need to reinstall Linux, or if you want to distro hop, it's going to make these kind of things really simple, because you only replace the root partition, and all your user files are safe and sound and don't change at all. The other approach suggests to only use one partition, both for your root folder and for your home folder as well. This is considered simpler, but even more importantly, it will prevent the situation that you have free space on your disk, but in the wrong partition. If you use two different partitions, moving the free space over is not that simple. So there is no one correct answer here. But personally, I usually just go with one big partition for both the root files and the user home files. So the use as is going to be ext4 journaling, and the mount point is going to be root. By the way, if you decide to go with two different partitions, all you would have to do is to decrease the size here, let's say something like this. And then for the root partition, the mount point would be this one, root. And for the home partition, the mount point would be this one, root, home. But as I said, I'm going to go with one big partition, so I'll allocate all of the free disk space. And the mount point is going to be root. And OK. So all of the disk space is used up. And we can see our EFI system partition, our swap partition, and our main partition, which is the root partition. We can also see it graphically over here. So the green one is the EFI system partition, the orange one is the swap area, and then the blue one is the root partition. So let's install now. and we need to confirm that we want to write the changes to the disk. We need to choose our location, and from here it's just the normal installation process where we need to provide a username, a host name, and let the installer do its thing.